Coming up, we'll take a look at the latest updates coming to Windows Autopilot. We're adding new capabilities to the zero-touch experience for deployment of new devices and also extending that zero-touch experience to device reset scenarios, all powered by Microsoft 365. With Windows Autopilot, our goal is to make the experience with new devices become magical for end users and at the same time simple and zero-touch for IT. We want to completely eliminate the cost and complexity incurred due to re-imaging new Windows 10 devices. We've now made it possible for hardware vendors to automatically register the Autopilot devices you acquire into your Azure AD tenant. All that IT needs to do is customize the setup experience for end users and the deployment configuration by creating an Autopilot profile. You can get the device delivered directly to your users. All the user needs to do is power the device on, connect to a network, and enter their organization credentials, and the device will get deployed into a fully business-ready state. It's managed, secured, and ready with the apps your users need to be productive. All of this is powered by Microsoft 365. Autopilot brings together Enterprise Mobility and Security Suite, Office 365, and Windows 10 into a single cohesive experience for IT as well as end users. With the latest updates, Windows Autopilot now spans each step in your device's lifecycle. Acquire devices, deploy the devices, and ongoing resets to your devices. Whether you need to transfer ownership of the device from one user to another or break fix a malfunctioning device, Windows Autopilot will enable a zero-touch IT experience to reset the device and bring it back into a fully business-ready state with a click of a single button in Intune. Let's dive into the details of all these new capabilities. With Windows 10 18.03, in the Autopilot out-of-box experience, after you enter your username and password, we're making it possible to block the device in the out-of-box experience until all of your configured policies, settings, and profile from Intune have been provisioned to the device before the user gets to the desktop. This is made possible with a new feature called Enrollment Status. After the device joins Azure AD and enrolls into Intune, the device can show the enrollment status until all policies, settings, and apps configured in Intune get provisioned. Configuring enrollment status in Intune is really simple. In the Windows Enrollment section, click on the enrollment status. I'm going to select all users group to apply the enrollment status to, click on the settings, and opt into displaying the enrollment status. You can choose to block the device, choose what actions users can take in case of unexpected failures, specify how long the device should stay in enrollment status, and even specify a custom message in case of errors. With hardware vendors' fulfillment systems automatically registering devices into Autopilot, we've made it really simple for these devices to be assigned an Autopilot profile. You no longer need to manually assign a profile to newly acquired Autopilot devices, thanks to integration with Azure AD device groups and Intune. All you need to do is create a dynamic device group to automatically induct Autopilot registered devices into the group and assign your profile to the group. In my case, I'm going to create a new group. Select the group type as security. I'll call the group All Autopilot Devices. For membership type, I will select dynamic device and create a dynamic query for group membership. In my case, I want all Autopilot devices to be assigned to this group. You can do this with a rule that looks for ZTD ID, that stands for Zero Touch Deployment ID. We automatically tag all Autopilot registered devices with a ZTD ID tag to make this really easy for you. Thereafter, go to your Autopilot profile and assign it to the appropriate group. So I'll click on Assignments for my Autopilot profile, find the group that I just created, and assign it to this profile. So in this case, I'm going to search for the All Autopilot Devices group, select that group and assign it to this profile. After this one-time setup, every new device registered into Autopilot will automatically get inducted into the dynamic device group. And because the group has an Autopilot profile assigned, all future Autopilot devices will deliver the experience automatically. There's nothing more for you to do, even for future Autopilot devices. There's also a number of additional capabilities we are making available in preview as a part of the Windows Insider program. First, we're taking the zero-touch deployment experience for new devices to the next level by making Windows 10 devices become self-deploying. When you configure Autopilot in self-deploying mode, all that's needed to deploy the device is power on and network connection. No need for a user to enter their username and password. The Windows 10 device will perform Azure AD join, enroll into Intune, and Intune will provision your policy settings apps using the enrollment status and get your device into a fully business-ready state. You can configure this device in Intune to be deployed as a lockdown kiosk with an auto logon account. In my case, I've locked this device down to a kiosk browser for browsing MicrosoftStore.com. You can also use the self-deploying mode to deploy an individual productivity device or a shared device. Our goal is to make the Autopilot deployment experience become zero-touch, not just for IT, but also for the person deploying the device. All they need to do is power on the computer. Configuring Autopilot in self-deploying mode is extremely simple. When you're creating an Autopilot profile, just select self-deploying for the deployment mode. In this case, I'm going to name a new profile browser kiosk, and for the deployment mode, I'm going to choose self-deploying. That's all you need to do to deploy a device in self-deploying mode. The next scenario we're really excited to make available in preview with the Windows Insider program is called Autopilot Reset. Now, you can remotely reset devices from Intune with the push of a single button and bring it back into a fully business-ready state without having to physically touch the machine. All you need to do is choose the device and then select Autopilot Reset to trigger it. While this will reset Windows 10 on the device, it'll persist your Azure AD join and Intune enrollment and automatically redeploy the device into a fully business-ready state. With enrollment status, you can be assured that the device gets all of its policies, settings, and applications before the user can access the desktop. Remember, all of this can be done without having to touch the device with the press of a single button in Intune. In my case, the device is going to come back as a browser kiosk just by having pressed a single button in Intune. So that was a quick overview of the latest innovation we are delivering with Windows Autopilot as we extend that zero-touch experience from IT to the end users and from device deployment to device resets. Remember, all major Windows 10 OEMs have committed support for automating their supply chain with Windows Autopilot. Microsoft Surface and Lenovo are already up and running, and we are working with Dell, HP, and others to bring this automation live soon. For the latest participating hardware vendors, check out the link shown. Also, if you're not already a member of the Windows Insider program, sign up now to get your hands on the latest innovation. And of course, please keep giving us your feedback. Thanks for watching.